We hope you'll stand by for a half a second because an old friend of mine is about to appear. He's been here about 97,000 times before. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, join me in greeting Mr. Jerry Butler. Very nice to see you again.
Thank you. Thank you.
How long ago was it before Your Precious Love came out?
Oh, 1958.
Doesn't seem like it would be that long.
It sure doesn't.
You know, we were reminiscing a little bit. So much happens as the years go by. Well, what's the most terrifying, humorous, unusual, strange... What's the funniest experience you've ever had? Maybe the most embarrassing?
Well, I think probably the most embarrassing thing was playing a theater, one of the well-known theaters in New York City. I rushed upstairs, changed clothes, ran downstairs, was doing my show, and right in the middle of For Your Precious Love, which is a very soulful type ballad thing, the whole audience just started giggling, you know, and the giggling
just
kept
breaking
getting
up?
Loud. Yeah, getting louder and louder and louder, and I'm trying to figure out what's happening. So finally, some little girl in the front row stood up and said, "You've got a roach on your jacket," you know.
Was he crawling up the side of you? What'd you do?
Well, I killed him and went on with the show.
How to destroy a beautiful ballad.
That's right.
Do you find that you can carry on no matter what happens?
Well, you know, we usually try to, the old tradition, the show must go on and all that sort of thing. Sometimes it's, you know, pretty near impossible. But as a rule, unless it's something that's just really way out, man, you just go on.
Sometimes you have to fall out. Where are you headed right after this? Tell me you're jumping on an airplane.
That's right. We're getting on a plane. We're going to do some colleges through Georgia and South Carolina. And then we go into Newark for a weekday engagement there.
All good luck. Have a happy travel.